the Quant series of 49 to 51. I hope you're enjoying it and it's full of learning for you. So today we are going to talk about the third GMAT trap related to algebra. And let's see how you fall in that. So it is knowing better about the square roots. Remember, square root of any number is always a positive quantity. And GMAT has actually exploited on this particular point a lot of times. Let's see. So there was a question in GMAT prep software only. It said something like this. It said y is equals to root of 3y plus 4. And we have been asked product of all the solutions or all the possible values of y. So we need to tell the product of all the possible values of y. What a person do over here, I'll let you know. See, you simply square, say y square equals to 3y plus 4, and finally say y square minus 3y minus 4 equals to 0. So once you are over here, it's quite easy to factorize it, and applying splitting the middle term, I reach to this point, y minus 4 and y plus 1 equals to 0, which gives me two things, that y equals to 4 and y equals to minus 1. Now the question asks us, product of all the possible values of y, and 4 into minus 1 looks like minus 4, but if you mark this answer, you are absolutely wrong, you will come back happy, yaar kiya to sab sahi tha, but ultimately, score kharab aayega. Why? You are gonna regret it because you did not know the concept. Look here, square root of a quantity is always positive. So y equals to minus 1 has to be neglected. You cannot say y is a negative quantity. Why? Because y is a square root of a quantity. So that means this particular equation has only one particular solution, that's y equals to 4. Minus 1 is not going to work. Once you see this kind of statement, always write y is greater than 0 before moving ahead, because it's a positive quantity. So minus 1 is neglected and the product of all the possible values of y is 4, not minus 4. So I hope this is clear. Whenever you see this square root quantity, remember, do not forget to write this part so that you don't make a mess of the question. So that's how GMAT plays. It seems like we are going correct, but actually we are. So this is the third trap. Remember, square root is always a positive quantity. Thank you. And make sure you subscribe us so that you do not miss such important concepts where GMAT is actually playing with us. We have a lot more and you'll see that in the coming videos.